time is coming, and now is, when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear will live. Because I live, you shall live also. I am the good shepherd. My sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and no one shall snatch them out of my hand. Peace, perfect peace, stands apart.
Mfon into the hands of the Almighty, who is the Father of us all. In the face of death, Christians have sure hope, faith and joy, knowing that our Lord Jesus Christ, who lived and died as we do, rose from death and lives forever. Therefore, through faith in him, we obtain eternal life. Therefore, let us come before him, so that we may receive the comfort of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Let me invite the cathedral band. to lead us as we praise and worship God.
What is the love? Hallelujah!
What is the love?
Please let's stand to our feet as we praise and worship God. Give us grace in the presence of death to worship you.
that we may have sure hope of eternal life and to be enabled to put whole trust in your goodness and mercy through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, giver of all comforts, deal graciously, we pray you to those who mourn, that by casting every care on you, they may know the consolation of your love through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord's Prayer. Father,
what in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, the glory, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated as we invite the Cathedral Choir to give us an anthem.
Thank you. What is the Lamb? May God bless choir in Jesus' name. Isaiah chapter 40, reading at verse 6 to 8. Isaiah chapter 40, reading at verse 6 to 8. A voice says, cry out. And I said, what shall I cry? All men are like grass, and all their glory is like the flowers of the field. The grass withers, and the flowers fall, because the breath of the Lord blows on them. Surely, the people are grass. The grass withers and the flowers fall, but the word of our God stands forever. The grass withers and the flowers fall, but the word of our God stands forever. Amen.
We take the gospel as recorded by St. Luke, chapter 16. The gospel as recorded by St. Luke, chapter 16. We read from verse 19 to the end of that chapter, verse 31. There was a certain rich man who was clothed in purple and fine linen, and fed sumptuously every day. But there was a certain beggar named Lazarus, full of sores, who was laid at his gate, desiring to be fed with the crumbs which fell from the rich man's table. Moreover, the dogs came and licked his sores. So it was that the beggar died and was carried by the angels to Abraham's bosom. The rich man also died and was buried. And being in torments, in Hades, he lifted up his eyes and saw Abraham afar off and Lazarus in his bosom. Then he cried and said, Father Abraham, have mercy on me, and send Lazarus that he may dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue. For I am tormented in this flame. But Abraham said, Son, remember that in your lifetime you receive your good things, and likewise Lazarus evil things. But now he is comforted, and you are tormented. And beside all these, between us and you there is a great gulf fixed, so that those who want to pass from here to you cannot, nor can those from there pass to us. Then he said, I beg you, therefore, Father, that you would send him to my father's house. For I have five brothers, that he may testify to them, lest they also come to this place of torment. Abraham said to him, they have Moses and the prophets, let them hear them. And he said, no, Father Abraham, but if one goes to them from the dead, they will repent. But he said to him, if they do not hear Moses and the prophets, neither will they be persuaded, though one rise from the dead. Neither will they be persuaded, though one rise from the dead. This is the gospel of Christ.
While we invite a member of the family to read the biography of our late father, we pray that if you have any condolence message or tribute that is not written or that is not found in this order of service, kindly submit that tribute or condolence message to the steward seated there so that we'll diligently hand it over to the family. The men's fellowship should also get ready for the rites, but at this point we will take the biography of our father.
Chief Atum Awana Mfon, elder statesman, veteran journalist and doyen of the press, was born in Inwa, in Imbo local government area of present Akwa Ibom State, Nigeria, in the early hours of Saturday, the 8th of August 1930, to the late Chief Elder Lawrence Awana Mfon and Princess Akum Awana Mfon. He hails from Iwa. Education. The young Atum Awana Mfon belonged to an all-male family of eight, five from his mother and three from his stepmother. His mother has serious reservations about his going to school, as she did not have a daughter to help her in domestic work. Apart from that, she was very uncomfortable at the way teachers gave corporal punishment to pupils in school. He began his primary education at Ross Memorial Primary School at Ebuku Central School, now Imbo local government area of Akwa Ibom State. He proceeded to the St. Paul's Commercial School in Aba, now Abia State, where he spent 3 years. He took RSS Senior School Certificate in the third year and passed with distinction in English language. At the same time, he also took the London Chamber of Commerce School Certificate and passed with distinction in Oral English. Career and working life. Chief Atum Awana Mfon spent almost all his working life in the journalism profession, which he came to embrace with deep fondness and relish. Journalism became to him a consuming passion. His first employment was in 1955 with Drum Publishers. Publishers of the Drum Magazine and African Drum, a sister publication that projected strong anti-apartheid views. It was published in Johannesburg, South Africa. After 3 months training in Lagos in marketing, he was posted to Port Harcourt, where he was in charge of the former Eastern Region and the Cameroons. He dutifully toured the two territories extensively, marketing the magazines and creating agents, despite his very tender age. At Port Harcourt, he resisted pressure from journalists to cross over to journalism from marketing. After 4 years, he was posted to Benin to be in charge of what today is Delta, Edo, Ekiti, and Ondo states. The pressure mounted on him by journalists to move to core journalism continued. In 1962, a journalist friend in Daily Times in Benin had gone back to Lagos to join the newly established but now defunct Daily Express. He told the editor, Chief Olu Adebanjo, who later became advisor on information and President Shehu Shagari in 1979, to send for him. He was given appointment as an editor without even applying for the job. The first story he ever wrote for publication in the newspaper earned him £800, 500 from his editor and 300 from his editorial advisor, Chief B.C. Olabanjo, who later became the first civilian governor of Ogun State. That story brought a change to his life for good. In the same evening of this publication, the editorial advisor, the editor, and the expatriate editorial director, Mr. Conrad, had a meeting and commended him highly, then posted him to Benin as chief of bureau of the company. This coincided with the time of renewed agitation for the creation of Mist West region. That piece was published in several other papers and earned him the nickname Great Eton among his colleagues. The Daily Express was a joint venture between the Amalgamated Nigerian Press and the Daily Express of London. It had three representatives, namely the editorial director, the production manager, and the technical director. The performance of Eton, Awana, and Mfon's official duties impressed the government in Benin, which recommended him for appointment as Reuters' new agent in the state. After the coup on August 13, 1967, Daily Times invited him to join the editorial staff without applying for the position. He depended on the job with Reuters for a living. In 1970, precisely 3 months after the Civil War, he was posted to the then southeastern state as chief correspondent of Daily Times. In 1973, he won the Commonwealth Press Union Scholarship in Nigeria for advanced course in journalism for senior journalists in Britain. There were 9 participants from 7 Commonwealth countries. The course included a 3-month program in Oxford University on international relations. They were official guests of Her Majesty's government for 2 weeks, during which they were taken around different parts of the country by different means of transportation. At the end of the tour, the House of Commons, the world's oldest parliament, held a session to enable the Press Union Scholarship team listen to the debate. On his return to Nigeria, the deputy managing director of the Daily Times was on hand to personally welcome him at the Muritala Muhammad Airport, Ikeja, Lagos. This was an act of honor from the newspaper. His cousin, Sir Eton Iyam, the former Inspector General of Police, was also at the airport to receive him. The deputy MD remarked to him, "Eton, we did not know you were such a powerful orator. We received reports about your activities in London. You did the company proud. We are proud of you." The MD, Alhaji Babatunde Ajose, would like to see you in his office tomorrow. Chief Eton Mfon was promoted to district manager of Daily Times and transferred to Enugu in 1980 to do administrative work. In 1982, a new role was created specifically for him as regional editor in charge of the then 12 states of the Federation with the regional head office in Calabar. This concession and honor was given to him because he declined to take up a senior management role at the head office in Lagos. After his retirement from Daily Times, the role which was created because of him and in recognition of his incredible performance was discontinued. In the course of his career, Chief Eton Awana Mfon's path crossed so many high-profile personages who were profuse with accolades and echoing for him. In the course of his career and working life, Chief Eton Mfon was recognized and given various appointments. He was made a councillor of Oral Local Government Council in a non-partisan election in 1976. In the same year, he was appointed a director in Cross River State Newspaper Corporation, publishers of Daily Chronicles and Sunday Chronicles. He was appointed director of the CRS television station, NYO, in 1983. He was a member of Board of Inquiry in the Cross River State Newspaper Corporation, with Professor Donald Etienne as chairman. He was chairman of Midwest Council of the Nigerian Union of Journalists. He was also chairman Southeastern State Council of the Nigerian Union of Journalists. Chidete Mfon ended his career in Daily Times in August 1992, where he excelled in investigative journalism. He was highly respected and admired by eminent citizens of all political persuasions. He resisted to the end the pressure from politicians to make him a card-carrying member of any political party, sticking with being a professional and ethical journalist, community service. The most enlightened and progressive Iwanrula, Ogbon Isseminabia, openly appreciated Chidete Mfon, who he attributed to have given Enwa a local government, a secondary school, and a Tory magistrate court, amongst others. As far back as 1970, he was made Secretary General, National Publicity Secretary of Enwa Development Union, an organization he co-founded in 1962. He mobilized and led the agitation and demand for the creation of a local government council for the riverine people of Igbo since his arrival in the state in 1970. He was Secretary General to a Fiatbo Council with late Chief Clement Anthony as chairman. He severally championed the development of his people, leveraging on the goodwill he enjoyed with various governments to the benefit of his people. He was passionate about uplifting the educational standard of his people and gave scholarship to several Iwan sons and daughters. In 1979, Chidete Mfon led the Efiatbo delegation to congratulate Dr. Clement Iso over his victory as governor in that year's election. He used that occasion to people's demand for a separate council status. The governor said to him, "Chief Mfon, you can go, I will give you what you have asked for. A panel will soon be set for the creation of Igbo local government areas. Go and prepare your memorandum now." The administration of Dr. Clement Iso created a Fiatbo local government area in 1981. Unfortunately, that local government and many others created by the civilian governors was abolished by General Muhammad Buhari when he took over power in 1984. Chief Mfon persuaded Governor Paul Omu to give his community a wooden pontoon to ferry people and goods across Igbo River. He worked hard to obtain the approval of the state government for Iwan Development Union to start a secondary school, the Iwan Community Comprehensive Secondary School. In 1985, he succeeded to get the Chief Judge of Cross River State, Justice Eden Koferen, to create a Tory magistrate court at Iwan. He was conferred with the chieftaincy title, the Pillar of Iwan, in 1980 for his outstanding contributions to the development and progress of Iwan, as well as giving Iwan good public image through sustained positive national and international publicity of Iwan Development Union, Christian Life. His father was among the first set of people to be baptized at the Methodist Church Ibaka in 1906. The Methodist Church had arrived there from Malabry, Equatorial Guinea in 1884. He became a Christian quite early in his childhood. He was baptized while in primary school at Ebugu Central School by Archbishop F.U. Ekanem at Ebugu. He lived an exemplary Christian life, pursuing peace and generating good deeds as his fruit spirit in life, family life. Chief Mfon was a devoted husband and committed father who disciplined his children and held them up for good character and virtue. He left behind his wife, Mrs. Teresa Mfon, 7 children and several grandchildren. Passage to glory. December 27, 2001 will always be a day to remember. On that day, Chief Etim Awana Mfon transited to glory peacefully in his residence in Calabar. May his gentle soul forever rest in the bosom of Jesus Christ. Amen. Worthy is the Lamb.
Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. We now invite to read the tribute, the representative from the Deputy Governor of Akwa Ibom State, to please come forward and read the tribute.
Church, praise the Lord. I'm just standing in for the Deputy Governor, who would have been here personally because of the exigency of duties. He could not come, but he was prepared to be here in person. I just want to take on his condolence message. It's about 8:04. In one time, the local government area. Condolence message. I'm sending you the condolences of my family and office over the demise of your father and my senior colleague, related to Awana Mfon of Mfon town in the local government area, who has passed on at the age of 91 years. A proven doyen of the media profession, the life and times of your departed father is a vintage story driven to share deeds of hard work and unyielding determination to succeed. After acquiring his education from such institutions as the Bull Central School in present-day local government area, and St. Paul's Commercial School of Art, Chief Mfon joined the Drum Publishers in 1955 and thereafter the Daily Times Group of Newspapers. I made this acquaintance when we met at Calabar, headquarters of the then Calabar Province, in 1960, when he had been posted as Chief Correspondent by the Daily Times in preparation to cover the inauguration of Nigeria's independence. I was also posted by the Daily Express newspapers at the same time to represent the paper in Calabar. He was indeed a quintessential professional with a burning desire to deliver. No wonder he rose to precipitously in his career, becoming in record time the regional editor, Southeast, and later regional editor, Southeast, South of the Daily Times of Nigeria before his retirement in 1992. He also served Akwa Ibom and Cross-River States in such important capacities as director, the Nigerian Chronicle, and director, Cross-River Television. He was counselor, Oron Local Government Council, and Secretary General of Efiatimbo in Oron Local Government area. The late media veteran was a member of the Methodist Church in Nigeria and contributed his quarter to the growth of the church. He was also a Christian man who demonstrated great passion for the development of his people. His departure deprived the media community in Nigeria, particularly Akwa Ibom and Gwadufas states, of the insight from his wide exposure and wisdom of his age and experience. I know that you and the family are more deprived by his death, but we should be consoled that Chief Mfon lived a long and fulfilled life, creating lasting legacies. As his remains are being committed to Mora Air, I join the family to celebrate this great journalism star and icon, hoping that his legacies will be sustained by those he has left behind. May his soul rest in peace. Moses F. Eko, MFR, Deputy Governor. Thank you very much for that opportunity given to me.
Thank you very much, sir. At this point, we welcome the Men's Fellowship right. Men's Fellowship. Men's Fellowship. It's your time now.
Worthy is the Lamb of God.
Hallelujah.
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 We've heard a lot about our late chief, our late member, our late brother, our late grandfather, great grandfather, a great journalist in the country and indeed in the world. He has made a lot of waves. No wonder he's an humble man. No wonder he's an honorable man. No wonder he's an Akwa Ibom Cross-River State man. No wonder he's a great Nigerian. So we thank God that he came to planet Earth and he sowed the seed of love, like his son said yesterday. And the other day, the wife also told us that he sowed the seed of peace. He sowed so many good seeds. The question arises, are we ready to also sow good seeds like our father has done? The answer should be yes, because he has done a lot of things and he has left behind great legacies. On that note, the wife told us 2 days ago that he liked one particular song, and that is hymn 944. So we shall take the first, second, and the last stanza of that hymn. And then the men fellowship will then render in 58565, which is our anthem. 585, which is our anthem. So we start with 944. Mendy. 944. Stanza 1, 2, and the last one. Now the day is over.
Amen. it is well, it is well, it is well, in the name of Jesus, it is well with our soul. Oh yeah.
Thank you, Men's Fellowship. I want all of us to stand as we observe a moment of silence. The soul of our father, Chief Etum Awana Mfon, rest in peace. In the bosom of the Lord, in the name of God the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Please let the congregation be seated while the family will continue to stand. Let us pray. Lord, I rest in your hand, rest in your hand. Oh God, I rest in your hand. Oh God, you are my salvation. Servant whom you brought into this life and kept him alive and gave him the grace and strength to do all that he did. We have gathered here to say, may your name be highly exalted forever. In the mighty name of Jesus, we lift up the family before you. Lord, we ask, O God, that your presence will continue to abide in this family. Lord, you help their father to do a lot. I ask that the children will exceed their father. In the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, you granted our dear father a long life. I pray the same will be applicable to the children. In good health they will live. No evil shall befall them. Lord, as they have done this to respect to their late father, I pray that wherever they enter, favor shall locate them. I declare that it is well with them. We lift up the church before you that you will continue to console the church. Continue to keep us in your love, in unity. Help us, Lord, to continue to look up to you in all conditions and in every situation of our lives. We lift up our nation, Nigeria, before you. More specifically, the government of Cross River State and Akwa Ibom State. I ask, O God, that you give your servant, the governors, and those in political positions, Father, to have passion. Grant them the grace to lead in your wisdom. I pray, Father, King of Glory, that as they execute the mandate you have given unto them, your spirit will lead them in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, as a church, we continue to pray for Nigeria. We pray that you will lead us and bless our leaders. Give them wisdom. Give them understanding. Grant them the passion about those whom you have committed into their trust.
I ask, O God, as a nation, that we continue to move forward in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, as a church, we ask, O God, And let there be peace in Ukraine. Let there be peace in Russia. I ask, O God, that you will rule and continue to reign in the hearts of your people. Thank you, Father, as we continue in this service.
We pray that your spirit will lead us. Lord, those who came to share in
this moment
of grief with this family, I ask, O God, that your presence,
your favor, will continue to locate your
people. And Lord, by the time they will go back, your presence will lead them safely. We soak them with the blood of Jesus. Those who have contributed in one way or the other for the success of this funeral, I ask that
horses
will never run dry. And I declare that the favor from the throne of grace will always locate them. Thank you, Heavenly Father. For
we have prayed with thanksgiving in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. You may be seated. The cathedral priest will preach the word of God to us this morning. We'll sing the hymn 976. 976.
we thank you for yet another opportunity given to your people to receive from you. We pray that you come and speak to us. Use me. May I only interpret your word. Have your way. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Please be seated.
The fountain of life is flowing everywhere. Whosoever drink shall never ever thirst again. The fountain of life is flowing everywhere. Whosoever will drink will never ever thirst again. I said the river of life is flowing everywhere. And whosoever drink shall never ever thirst again.
I thank God for preserving our lives. I thank God for bringing us together this day in His presence, for Him to speak to us again. Let me also thank the cathedral administrator for giving me this opportunity to stand before these wonderful people of God. I recognize the presence of all the presbyters in the chancel and other ministers, the leaders of the church, the knights of the church, the choristers, the band, the politicians that are here, men and women from far and near. You are all welcome in the name of Jesus Christ. It is laid in my heart to speak from the gospel of Christ as documented by St. Luke chapter 16 as we read. I want to take verses 22 to 25. And it occurred that the man reduced to begging died and was carried by the angels to Abraham's bosom. The rich man also died and was buried. And in Hades, the realm of the dead, being in torment, he lifted up his eyes and saw Abraham far away and Lazarus in his bosom. And he cried out and said, Father Abraham, have pity and mercy on me, and send Lazarus to dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue, for I am in anguish in this flame. But Abraham said, Child, remember that you in your lifetime fully received what is due you in comforts and delights, and Lazarus in like manner the discomforts and distresses, but now he is comforted here and you are in anguish. This morning, or afternoon rather, I want to speak on what I captioned, quench the thirst now. Quench the thirst here and now. You can put it this way, cool off now. Can you help me tell your neighbor, cool off now. Quench the thirst here and now. The importance of our water to human life cannot be overemphasized. Many a times as human beings, if you eat without water, you will discover that you will be in trouble. Many people in the Bible, there was a time in their lives when there was they were in need of water. Their throat dried and they cried for water. I could remember one of them, a strong man, very powerful, a man who conquered many soldiers, a man who killed lion, a man who was able to remove an iron gate of a city. The Bible recorded a time in his life, in Judges chapter 15, verse 18, his throat was very dry, and his strength reduced. And he cried out to God and said, how are you going to allow me to die? I am thirsty. God, come to my rescue. The Bible recorded that God immediately caused water to come from nowhere. And Samson drank, and his strength was renewed. David was also another powerful man who fought many battles. At a time, his throat was also dried, and he needed to quench that thirst. In 2 Samuel chapter 23, verse 15, David cried and said, how wish that somebody would go to Jerusalem and get me some water to drink. Even our Lord Jesus Christ, during his earthly ministry, when he was concluding his mission here on earth, according to John chapter 19, verse 28, the Bible said, when he discovered that the end has come, when he discovered that he has fulfilled the mission, the purpose for which he came, he said, I am thirsty. His throat became dry because of me, because of you. Brethren, we know what the devil did in the Garden of Eden. How he took from our forefather, the first man created by God, how he deceived him and took away the glory of God from him and transferred a great heat upon him, which Jesus called a heavy laden. This continued to create a heavy heat on every human being that causes every human being born into this planet Earth from time to time to have thirst, to have a need to quench a thirst. It has been the plan of God right from the beginning, right from the fall of man, to reconcile human beings unto himself. When our forefather Adam sinned against God, we know that it was God who started the reconciliation process. In Genesis chapter 3, verse 9, there was a call. God asked the question, Adam, where are you? God started to look for man, and not man looking for God. That continued for many years. In one way or the other, God had been calling for people to come back unto himself. In the time of Isaiah, the Bible records in Isaiah chapter 55, verse 1, when God saw the way his people, the people chosen by him, and set them apart, when they were on their own ways, they forsook God. Everybody became something else, in contrary to the plan of God. And God began to make a call. The Bible says in Isaiah chapter 55, verse 1, it says, listen, wait and listen. Everyone who is thirsty, come to me. I will give you water free of charge. Any person who is thirsty, please come. I will give you a free water
you are not going to pay to cool off. Brethren, the Bible made it clear from the passage we read. It pictured what is going to take place after here on earth. We had a picture of two people, a rich man and a poor man. In the world, there are only two people, you and others. You may be among the rich, you may also be among the poor. Men with great influence, political groups, men with academic prowess. As we read in Isaiah chapter 40, one thing is certain about these two men, the rich and the poor. In Isaiah chapter 40 verse 6, the Bible says, Isaiah heard a voice and God said, make a proclamation. Cry out. He said, what am I going to cry out for? He said, tell people that all human beings, both thick and tall, they are nothing but flowers that can easily wither at any given time. Please help me tell that person sitting beside you, you are nothing but a flower. Please help me tell another person by the other side. Tell him or her, you are nothing but a flower. And you can wither away at any time. Yes! On Monday we were told, if you are not present here, you will be absent. That when you are absent here, you will be present somewhere. That was during the opening of Morning House. Absent here, present there. You cannot run away from it. If you are not present here, you are present somewhere. Though we are seeing our Father's corpse present here, but he's absent. But one thing I know is that he is present somewhere. Worthy is the Lamb. The Bible said these two men once lived here on earth. One of them took time to look for this life-giving water. He took enough water while he was alive. But the other man was interested in his sumptuous food. He cared nothing about the poor. He used his political power to oppress others, as we are seeing in our own time. As a nation, in our various states, when the biography of our father was being read by the daughter, she came to a particular line, and there was murmur in the crowd. What shall you be remembered when you are no more here? Many local governments were created for expansion, for development. Somebody came up and scattered everything. I could remember in those days when those local governments were created, my side was also was among them. We drove from our place to a far place where they cited the local government, singing that we now have a new local government. But when that same man came and scattered everything, today we are still suffering it. If you allow me, I will tell you that my present local government is the biggest local government in the whole Nigeria, and one of the oldest local government in Nigeria, being the local government area of Abia State. Today, we are still suffering. And people are still clamoring for 2023. So was it with this man, the rich man, he didn't care for the purposes. But the Bible said one day, when the owner of life came, the clock of his life stopped. One day, in a twinkling of an eye, the clock of our lives will stop. At the beginning of the month of December, I visited our Papa, as it had been our normal routine every month to visit the weak and the aged ones, to pray with them and to give them Holy Communion. I visited him. He was alive, he was sound. But on the 27th, when I traveled, the following day, I received a call on 28th, that Papa, that the clock of his life has stopped. Who knows the next person after this moment? The rich man died. The poor man also died. If you take the very careful notes of what happened there, the poor man first died, Abi. Eh? The poor man died, and the Bible did not mention that he was buried. Probably he died, nobody cared to bury him. But when the rich man died, there was a befitting burial. Probably they used gold and constructed his jacket. And he was buried. But the Bible recorded, after their departure here on earth, that a poor man was found resting, being comforted in the bosom of Abraham. But the rich man saw himself in a great torment. And he made a request as a father. My throat is dry. Please send Lazarus to dip just one of his fingers to cool off my throat. And Abraham said to him, it is too late. That is why I am telling you now to quench the thirst now. It is better you cool off now, before it will be too late. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Jesus in John chapter 7, verse 37. Made a cry before the public. The Bible said, at the conclusion of a particular festival, he stood just the way I am standing now. And he said, whosoever that is thirsty, let him come. I am the life-giving water. If you will drink, you will not make request over him. If you will receive it now, your throat will be quenched here and forever. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. God is still interested in you because he created you. That's why he's still making this call. Even Jesus, after his death and resurrection, in Revelation chapter 21, verse 6. Revelation chapter 22, verse 17. He made the seventh call. He said, whosoever that will drink, now that you are alive, that such a person shall never thirst again. There are biblical examples of men and women or women who drank while they were alive. In Psalm 42, verses 1 and 2, the sons of Korah, they made a statement and said, as hearts pant for brooks of water, so is my heart longs after you. To quench the thirst is by longing, seeking your Creator now that you are still alive. Ecclesiastes 12, verse 1 says, remember now your Creator while you are still a youth, while you are still alive. In Psalm 63, verse 1, David also made this statement. He said, my inner heart, my inner self, my soul longs for thee. Seeking after God, seeking to do His will, that's what it means. To quench the thirst. When Jesus met the Samaritan woman in John chapter 4, He introduced Himself as the life-giving water. If you read verses 4, verses 10 and 14, He said, I am that living water. If you will accept me, your throat will be quenched. And in verse 15, the Bible said that this woman said what? Give me that living water. I want it. I need that living water now. And Jesus told her, go and call your husband. And she said, I don't have any husband. Jesus said, you are right. You have married to five men. Even the one you are living with now is not your husband. The man you are living with, is he your husband? The woman you are living with, is she your wife? Delay is very, very dangerous. It is now or never. Jesus is still calling on us to take this water as we are hearing the word of God. By surrendering your life totally to the word of God. In Psalm 119, verse 174, when you long for the salvation that is in Christ Jesus. In Psalm 143, verse 6, when you surrender your life totally to Christ, then that's what it means to quench the thirst now. The Bible made it clear that there are benefits of drinking that water now. In Matthew chapter 5, verse 6, Jesus said, blessed are those who are hungry now, those who thirst for righteousness, those whose heart desire is to live a righteous life, uncompromised life, uncorrupted life, uncorrupted life. He said they are blessed. Again, he said in Revelation chapter 7, verse 16, that such people shall never ever thirst again. But there is danger if you fail to quench the thirst now. Amos chapter 8, verses 11 and verse 8, verse 12. Amos chapter 8, verses 11 and 12. The Bible said, a day is coming when what happened in the Hades will happen again. The Bible said there shall be a time when people shall look for the word of God, when they shall look to hear the word of God, but they will not find it. The only time you have is now, irrespective of your position, irrespective of what you think you are, if you fail to repent of your sins, as Jesus said in Luke chapter 13, verse 3, repent or you perish. This is the only time. Quench the thirst now, or you will cry like that rich man whom Abraham told, it is too late. But you have the opportunity now. Shall we pray? The choice is yours. The message is not for chief, Mfon, but the message is for the women. Are you willing at this moment to surrender your life to Christ? If you are willing, He's ever ready for you. If you are willing and you want to do this, I want you to repeat after me. Lord Jesus, I thank you for your word. I am a sinner and I cannot save myself. I ask you to come into my life. Come and save me. Give me the power to become your own child. Quench my thirst right now so that I will not cry at last. This is my earnest prayer. May it be so unto you, in the name of Jesus Christ. Anthem by the Cathedral Choir.
round of applause for the choir. Please clap for the choir. Worthy is the Lamb.
Hallelujah.
Our Daddy Chief lived up to the age of 91, and we have heard testimonies right from the day of the opening of Morning House till now of the beautiful seeds he sowed. We are going to give an offering in support of evangelism. When we talk about seed sowing, then we know that evangelism is involved. It is offering, it's a very special offering in support of evangelism. And then we will take offering in support of the family. Please stand up with whatever you have. You have 1,000 naira. Please come forward and support the work of evangelism. Do it on behalf of Chief, who will have happily do it. You have the opportunity to key into the seats he has been sowing. There is a tray in front here. Come forth with your substance. But please just give a very soft music while people will come and be dropping their support. Or whatever you have, 1,000 naira, 500 naira, please come. We have huge evangelism project to embark on. Please, you can come from the back. Please, you can come. Just keep coming.
Jesus, I've got something more to go. I'll turn it to the world.
Please approach.
Jesus is more than gold.
Nothing is to be.
Something more than gold.
the bereaved family have spent in different ways in putting the funeral service of your father together. We are going to give support of them as friends that you have come to back them up. You are going to give your token to support that family. This family, please give your financial support to the family. It will help in one way or the other. Please, you are admonished this time before we take our general offering, please. Friends, please come and support the family. This is for the family. Please, a special offering for the bereaved family. The band, please give us something soft. Special offering for the bereaved family. Please, just in like manner, whatever denomination, please support the bereaved family. This will be handed over to the family.
We bring the sacrifice of praise into the house of God.
Offering for the family, please.
We bring
what else, please? Help us
into the house.
Our guests from the
sacrifice, seeds of faith.
91 years, or considering was approaching 100. Daddy lived up to 91 years, so we are not really folding our hands, even though we're mourning, but in some aspects we are celebrating him, especially for the fact that he lived a good life. So I encourage you to come dancing and celebrating and offer in the presence of God as the band will lead us with choruses for us to give our general offering.
What is the Lamb? It's time to praise and rejoice for the life well spent. Can we say Daddy lived the life? He lived his life well. Can we say life well spent? If you agree with me, give a wave offering unto the Lord. 91, no be boy boy. Nakara is not. Hallelujah. There is no There is nobody like you. Nobody.
and his name is Yahweh. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. We will be inviting the family for family Thanksgiving. For just as they are arranging to come, we'll invite children from the Precious Children Academy to give their special presentation and then the family Thanksgiving. Children from Precious Children Academy, please come forward. We are waiting for you. Your time is already counting. You have 3 minutes. Precious children, be precious. Keep on. Please, family, get ready. I don't know if you are coming to another way or you're coming from the way. So I really need to make step out. You come from the time period. Please encourage the children, just laugh at them.
For all you, the Lord shall preserve your soul. street. For in the time of trouble, he shall hide you up in his pavilion, in the secret place of his tabernacle. He shall hide you up.
Ephesians 6, verse 10. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of
God. Matthew 6, verse 12. May the Lord deliver you all from all evil. Amen.
Precious children from Precious Children Academy. Please encourage them. What a wonderful presentation to console with the family of Chief. Please, the family is designed for Mutasi. Please, just come from where you are. Please, family members, it is time for Mutasi. Please, some of you will stay here for the altar. You know, please, family, it's time for family thanksgiving. Lord of the Lord. Very close friends can decide to join them. Family, please. Come for your dad's game.
Yeah,
is there a song you want? Please have one with him number 10.
What is the Lamb?
Hallelujah.
you know, for the life that he had given unto our father. Indeed, it was really the hand of God upon his life. And we are grateful, you know, that God had kept him until age 91. Those of us that knew him, if you were very close to him, 1992, he retired from service, and right from 1992, he was partially blind. Then after some years, he became totally blind. But we thank the Lord, you know, that kept him, even unto the day he passed on. I thank the Lord that, you know, in his usual way, he would call each and every one of us and say, and give us a list, asking for his Christmas package. Praise the Lord. And when I waited for that list to come, that list was all forthcoming. Then I knew that the time was near. Praise the Lord. And my father was somebody that never disturbed us. He never in his life, you know, all through that trial, he never accepted to leave the house to go to the hospital. If you tell him, you know, let's take him to the hospital, he would say no, then, you know, the doctors will call me, you know, to see him. But when they called me and told me that, you know, my dad accepted for the doctor to come and see him, because we had been persuading him to get hearing aid, he said no. But when they now told me he has accepted to get the hearing aid, I knew something was wrong. Praise the living God. So I am standing here, you know, to thank the Almighty God for his life. Those of you that knew him, he was a jolly good fellow. Praise the Lord. If you got the opportunity to meet him, I tell you, 12 hours is not enough for you to, you know, have an interaction with him. If you go there, know that you are booking a hotel in Calabar for you to spend time with my dad. So I thank God for his life. I thank God for keeping him. I want to thank those, especially the church, you know. God bless Wesley Cathedral in the mighty name of Jesus. You know, we have heard, you know, we are not with him, but we've heard how from time to time, every month, we don't miss visiting him. You don't miss, you know, taking stops to him. I pray that the Lord God Almighty will replenish your pockets, will replenish your stock in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And that whenever, you know, you need people around you, God Almighty will provide people, you know, to comfort you in the mighty name of Jesus. May the Lord be praised in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I know the family, you know, are given something. I will add two more pieces. Praise the living God.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I'm just thanking to God for the life of my father. I was thanking God by saying that his life was an inspiration. You know, just thinking of him and looking at how he lived his life just inspires me. I just can't imagine that somebody could actually live the kind of life that he lived. I've lost many friends on account of meeting my dad. They will become friends with my dad. And when they come to the house, they will ask for my dad, interact with him, and get ready to go. And I will appear and say, you mean you've been around? And they say, I've been talking with daddy. And they have that sense of satisfaction. That's the, not minding the age difference. That was the kind of person he was. He went through challenges in life that you would never imagine what he was going through naturally. It's incredible. He would encourage you. He will inspire you. Sometimes I wonder, how is he able to spare time to speak words of encouragement? Not minding that he was confined in the house for over 30 years. 30 years that you can't imagine when you sit around him. He's telling you what is happening in America. He's telling you the election, who is going to win the election, and all of that. We thank you very much. We are just grateful to God for giving him to us as a father. Thank you very much. I'll just put my sister's steps. She's older than me, so I'll do exactly what she did. Thank you.
You know that we are dealing with children. Their father was a journalist, so they like to talk. And you can see the biography they wrote. So we are not in doubt. God will continue to bless you.
Amen.
Great men and women will come from this family.
Amen.
As you have honored your great father, heaven will honor you.
Amen.
Let us pray. Eternal Father, we thank you for a day like this. It is always good and pleasant for your people to come out to appreciate you for all your goodness and mercies in the life of your children. We continue to commit this family before you, that you continue to strengthen them. The good legacies their father left behind, they will continue to follow them and do more. Lord, we pray that no premature death will come to any member of this family. We soak them with the blood of Jesus. Father, we ask, O God, that as we be going for the interment, your presence will continue to lead us. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank you. God bless you.
Where is the land? Please can the family please come back? Thank you. We know you have gone through a lot, you have spent so much. So as a church, we are giving this little token to you to offset some of your debts.
Praise the Lord. The song says, it's love, it's love, it's love that makes the world go round. It's love, it's love, it's love that makes the world go round. It's love, it's love, it's love that makes the world go round. It's love that makes the world go round. For you and me, it's love that makes the world go round. For you and me, it's love that makes the world go round. For you and me, it's love that makes the world go round. It's love that makes the world go round. On behalf of the family, I stand to say to the church that we appreciate the table. May God continually bless you in Jesus' name.
What is the land? We continue to do some things. We are actually giving this back to the church to use it to put a pew, to pass the pew. Thank you very much.
God is the Lord. On behalf of the ministers and members of this church, I welcome all of you to this cathedral in Jesus' name. And we invite you to worship with us on Sunday, the 10th of April 2022. We'll be celebrating Palm Sunday. And we start with the procession by 9 a.m. So you are all welcome in Jesus' name. Our 40 days prayer continues tomorrow by 6:30 a.m. You are all invited. Also on Sunday, we have Boys Brigade Awana. You are all invited in Jesus' name. At this time, I want to welcome our dignitaries from far and near who have come to mourn with us. I want to start with Mr. Okoto Brothers. He is representing the Deputy Governor of Akwa State, Mr. Moses Ego. You are welcome in Jesus' name. I also welcome the Chairman of the Nigeria Union of Journalists in Kosova State and the ESCO members. You are welcome in Jesus' name. We also have a representative of the Nigeria Union of Journalists at Akwa State.
The members, you are all welcome in Jesus' name. We also have the League of Veteran Journalists represented by Mr. Sonny Anton. Please, if you are here, you can wait to the church. You are welcome in Jesus' name. Also on my list, I have Barrister Aide Akpanka, Senior Advocate of Nigeria. We have Engineer Daniel Amoke, Professor Francis Bishop and his dear wife. You're welcome in Jesus' name. Engineer Sam Popola, Engineer Kola Adegoke and wife, Mr. Shola Ajayi, you're welcome in Jesus' name. Also, Mr. Kola Osunye and wife, Mr. Amos Gaga and wife, Mr. Sonny Agola, you're welcome in Jesus' name. Mr. Stanley Koko and wife, Mr. Bayo Akunsaya, Mr. Chiemeka Ngoru, Mr. Dela Akindele, Mr. Shegun Akinyemi, Mr. Johnson Egedama, you're welcome in Jesus' name. I also welcome members of the Labour Union, the presidents and all the executives, and all family members from Iran. You are all welcome in Jesus' name. We also welcome the in-laws from the Asia family, cousins from Asaba, Delta State, in-laws from Ekiti State, in-laws from the Ekos family. You are all welcome in Jesus' name. We have Mr. Freedom Imala, Mr. Felunjo, Mr. Mwambe Oseban Gomade, Mr. Obi Ogochi and wife, Mr. Emma Omar, Mr. David Udom and wife, Mr. Eliop and... Okay, that's Mr. Obi. You are all welcome in Jesus' name. God bless you. And grant you journey blessings back to your different destinations. Any announcement from the family? Okay, the reception is at Verishan Mall along Highway. The closing hymn.
We will bring this service to close as we say from Matthew's in the hymn number 615.
standing would take the death match himself.
Please, are you
Hallelujah.